Hello and welcome back to my channel. Let's talk about trace today. For the ones of you who don't know, trace is a product that Shaper Tools announced that will be out soon that allows people to trace their sketches. And I've had a couple of viewers comment on videos and ask me about my opinion about trace. And so this is a video about trace, and it's also a video showing you alternatives on how to get your sketches onto your computer and into an SVG if you are not willing to buy trace. All right, so trace is a little aluminum frame with dominoes that you put over a hand sketch that you did, and then using an app, you can import that into the app, and the app will then automatically trace your hand sketch and convert it into an SVG. And from the documentation I see on the website, it looks easy to use and like pretty neat in the sense that it automatically does all of that, and it smooths the line and makes sure like the SVG looks more or less nice. When I saw this announcement, I first didn't even understand what it is. And then when I saw what it was, I was confused. Not because I think it's a bad product, but because I simply don't have that need. I don't have the use case where I draw something on a piece of paper and then I need it on the computer and convert it into an SVG to use on the Shaper Origin. I think I needed this once in the last 4 years or something like that. So it's not something that I need frequently. The main reason I don't need this frequently is because I actually stink at hand drawing and I stink at like sketching and that kind of stuff. So that is not a skill of mine. Therefore, there's not a lot of need for me to actually have that on the computer, or let alone like use them on a Shaper Origin. So I didn't need that. And the workflows I have and how I use the Shaper Origin doesn't really require that. So I mostly use SVGs that I create on the computer or I buy them. And there is a video showing you how to get to different SVGs. So check it out if you're interested in that. But if that is something that you need a lot, if you frequently sketch stuff and you need it on the computer, I do think there is a value in this product. So you'll have to decide for yourself if that's something you do frequently. In the case where this is not something you do frequently, but sometimes you need a sketch on the computer, there's other ways that are cheaper, that are free to do that. And this is a video where I will show you how to do that in case you need it. But overall, my opinion about trace is that I simply don't need it. That's why I will not buy it. But I do not think it is a stupid product. There are things that are questionable. For instance, the aluminum frame that they sell you. Do you really need that? Could they not just simply license you the app for a certain fee? And then you just create a frame yourself, right? Of the size that you need. I do think that is kind of like a trick to get you to buy something and spend some money. So that could be done cheaper, but the app looks really neat, and there is obviously that good software costs money. So if that is something you need, you should absolutely invest in this. And if not, here's how you can do it if you don't want to invest that money. Let's assume you sketch something, and because I stink at sketching, I just did this, a smiley, that's as far as I can get, right? When you have this, you need to import it into your computer. There's two ways to do that, well, there's maybe more ways, but like there's two ways I can tell you. One is you have a scanner, and if you have a scanner, you can just scan that and then you have it in your computer as a PNG, for instance. If you don't have a scanner, you can also do that using your phone. There is an app that is called Photo Scanner, which is free, and I'll put the link in the description of this video, that you can use to get this onto your phone in a way that it's actually flat, right? If you just take a picture, You might not have your phone like in the perfect angle, and it might be distorted. What PhotoScanner does, it's actually a software to import analog pictures, like old pictures, onto your phone. And what you do is like you follow the scan in different dots that are shown on the screen, and that way it will be like really flat and of high quality. So let me show you how to do that, and then after this I'll show you all the other steps that you have to do to convert this to an SVG. You open the PhotoScanner app and you hover over your sketch, and then you press the button to record, and you will see those bubbles that you have to follow one after the other. And so with every step, the PhotoScanner takes multiple photos and then extrapolates your picture. And that's pretty much it. All right, assuming that you have scanned your picture and you have it like this, you see this comes from PhotoScanner. The first step that you need to do is you need to convert this to a black and white bitmap. So an image that has only black and white pixels on it. And an easy and free way to do that is to go to a website called Resize Pixel. There you can upload your image. Here you can crop it if you want. You can just select the piece that you need and then crop it. And you can select black and white here, and you go black and white only, and you do conversion, and now you can download it. And now we see that this one here has only black and white information, while the one that you scanned originally has grays in it, the paper that wasn't completely white, these kind of things. So you need to remove that information, and you can do that this way. All right, so now I have this smiley, black and white, and the next step is that you go to Inkscape. Inkscape, for the ones of you who don't know, is a tool that is free that you can download. I'll leave you the link in the description. And with this, that's a vector editing software. So once you open Inkscape, what you simply do is you drag and drop your smiley into Inkscape, and you see here we have it. All right, so you have your smiley, and to convert that into a vector, you go to path and then to trace bitmap, and here you will have different settings. Every time you click the update button, it will show you a preview. I'm not an expert in this, but what I found out is that the brightness cutoff is the one that works best if you want to convert this into a vector that has two lines for the outer and the inner line of your stroke. And if you want to have only one line, then you go here to centerline tracing, which will then like choose the middle of those two lines and have one vector. So I'll go here for brightness cutoff, and then you see you have a bunch of different parameters that you can play with. And again, I'm not the expert, so what you will have to do is you need to fiddle around, like try out different settings and see how this is working and how it works for your particular sketch. Now I'll leave this all in defaults, and I will click OK. Now it did already create my vector, so I can close this dialog. And what you see here, now we have two. This one, the left one, is a vector, and this, the right one, that's the bitmap. So the bitmap we can delete, we don't need that anymore. And here you see that these are lines, right? So this is a vector. You can now import that into your shape origin. You first need to select the right color to know if it's like a pocket cut or an inline, outline cut, these kind of things. But that's like standard. But now with this, you can work. The second option that I've showed you is if you go to Trace Bitmap, that you choose the centerline tracing. And if you do that and you convert your image, you will see that it looks really different. So this here is now your vector. And what it did is it created one line. So each line is like one line. It created automatically the center for this. And so that's obviously like a very different shape. And depending on what you need, you might choose one or the other. All right, that was it. There's not much more to add. I hope this video is helpful to you. If it is, or if it's not, if you have any ideas about other videos to do about the shape origin, then leave it in the comments. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up, to subscribe to my channel, and see you around.